Good evening. Severe storms are sweeping the southeast with thousands of homes right now without power and weather warnings in place as we go to air.
The powerful rain, wind and hail forced a suspension of all flights in and out of Brisbane as days of heat gave way to summer storms.
As the ominous warning signs rolled in, we all knew what was coming. But somehow the severity of the wild weather still caught many off guard. Brisbane City quickly becoming a whiteout, a battering of rain partnered with flashes of lightning.
But as it comes in, it will trigger the potential for thunderstorms and severe thunderstorms during this afternoon and early evening as it moves northwards.
Thunderstorm warnings issued from the Wide Bay and Burnett all the way down to Coolangatta and the Darling Downs, but the primary concern is rainfall.
Could see isolated falls, particularly under some of the severe storm activity, you know, of 50 to 100 mil wouldn't be out of the question as this change rolls up.
Rosalie copping 73 millimetres in an hour, while at Mount Cutha, 46 millimetres fell in just 30 minutes, leaving exposed rooftops with little chance. Those caught outside could do little to keep out the sudden big wet, try as they might to shield themselves, and after days of oppressive heat, the southeast finally felt an icy blast. Large hailstones bouncing off backyards. Residents at Camp Hill watching the downfall from their veranda. The hail so intense, even local birds were forced to seek shelter. While at Mwillimbah, parked cars were quickly submerged by flash flooding, a nasty surprise for drivers.
Let's go straight to Nick Kelly at Brisbane Airport now, where the wild weather is affecting travellers. Nick, a number of flights have been delayed this evening.
Yeah, good evening, Melissa. Things are slowly returning back to normal here, but there is quite a backlog to clear. Several dozen flights were delayed this afternoon when ground operations had to come to a halt for a bit over an hour due to lightning threats in the area. For the most part, flights could still take off and leave, but the delay came from the fact that for safety reasons, staff simply couldn't be out there on the tarmac loading and unloading things like baggage and catering. There was one flight from Doha which needed to be diverted to Sydney due to storm activity during its landing window. It's currently refueling down there and is expected to arrive back here in just over a couple hours' time. On a slightly unrelated note, two flights to Auckland needed to turn around and return back here to Brisbane this afternoon due to the inclement weather down there. But Andrew, there may be a few less people watching us tonight as we go to air right now. There's a bit over 7,000 homes in southeast Queensland still without power.
It's been a bit wild, Nick. Thank you. Well, let's bring in weather expert Gary Youngbury, who's at Kangaroo Point tracking the storms. Where are they now, Gary?
Well, Andrew, there's been a new warning issued. It is west of Brisbane. It is for the Toowoomba Council areas and also the Southern Downs. So a few storms skirting Toowoomba at the moment. West of Warwick and Stanthorpe is currently in the firing line. But here across the southeast, a little closer to the coast, I want to show you the radar, how the afternoon unfolded. Isolated storms became this widespread band of severe thunderstorms, dumping 60 to 70 millimetres in less than an hour. Topping the rain gauges has been Rosalie with 73 millimetres. Also, plenty of hailstones around the city and suburbs, some of the largest recorded in Mount Gravatt, the size of golf balls. We still could see some storms in Brizzy. It is a little clearer at the moment, but more on your full forecast a little later from Kangaroo Point.
Talk to you then, Gary. Thank you. Parts of the state remain in the grips of a fire emergency tonight, with out-of-control bushfires continuing to wreak havoc on small communities in the Western Downs.
Residents there forced to evacuate, leaving their lives and homes behind as crews work around the clock to try to contain several fires.
This is the wall of flames confronting firefighters, heading into the danger zone as residents flee.
If the fire just comes from all directions to your house, I couldn't take it. I got into my car and I took off.
As quickly as the inferno arrived on Alice Bosch's doorstep, so too did strangers, creating a fire break around her Mile Park home.
They saved our house. They really saved our house.
But other homes have been destroyed, though exactly how many is still unclear. Darren Sutton among those now homeless.
I've lost everything. All my clothes are like, these are the clothes that I've got.
Along with four horses at their temporary showgrounds home.
People that have been burnt out will have a long road, yeah. Yeah, you feel sorry for them.
Only a few allowed back through roadblocks at their own risk.
We lost everything there, the shed and the structure and everything's gone, but that's better than losing lives.
So that's the most important thing.
Trudy Watson seeking refuge at the Miles Caravan Park for now.
Say it's a 50-50 chance at the moment whether it'll be saved.
Raindrops falling on the fire ground this afternoon as exhausted crews work around the clock in trying conditions.
So the weather that we're experiencing, the fire is moving into an unstable atmosphere. So for us, that causes concerns around firefighter safety. It means that the fire has the potential to become quite erratic.
This is just part of the 26,000 hectares of land that has already burned, but one of the other dangers is that these trees are still burning from the inside and could fall at any time. This footage taken on the ground at nearby Tara, where the largely contained blaze has left more than 20 structures in ruin, each of these communities vowing to wrap their arms around each other.
Being such a short, like small town and stuff like that, and they don't know you for a bar of soap, but willing to come out and help.
Live now to Kate Lamb at Miles on the Western Downs. Kate, there's help on the way though tonight for exhausted emergency crews.
There is, Andrew. Up to 60 extra crews are expected to come here over the next week from across the state to help take over from the firefighters who've really been up against it here. You would have thought that some of those light showers that we saw earlier today could have been some relief for them, but it doesn't seem to have necessarily been the case. Some firefighters telling me that lightning is believed to have sparked two other fires either side of where we are here in Miles, those blazes at Drillam and at Collumbola. But Melissa, either way, no doubt it'll be a very long night ahead for many here.
I'm sure it will be. Kate, thank you.